Hey everybody, hello, how are you? Thank you for stopping by my channel today. Welcome back. If you're new, my name is Cheryl Horvath and I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator in Woodinville, Washington. And today I have a super fun card that I want to show you how to make. I posted this on one of my Facebook channels the other day and I had an overwhelming response of people wanting to see a quick tutorial on how to make this card. So I'm going to do that for you. But before I start, I just wanted to remind everybody that currently, if you're watching this today, or I should say, let's see, July, sometime in July, today's the 11th, by the way. If you're watching it in July, there is a Designer Series paper sale going on until August the 2nd, and that will give you 15% off a select choice of 3, 6, 9 different Designer Series papers. When I flip the camera around, I'll show you the flyer real quick, but 15% off. So if it is $11.50, typically that's what you pay for a pack of 12 by 12 paper. It's your new cost is only $9.78. So pretty significant savings. I'm definitely taking advantage of it. Shh, don't tell my husband. So yeah, that's happening now between and ending on August the 2nd. And so here's just a quick little sneak peek at the flyer. I'll flip that camera around too. So let's see, what else did I want to say? I think that's it. So I'm going to turn the camera around and we're going to get started and I'm going to show you the card that we're going to make. Here's the flyer I was telling you about. These are the 6 papers that you can choose from. This is the Beauty of the Earth one, the plants, one of my favorites, which is the Year of Peach. I don't own this one, and I've just ordered a ton of that one because Christmas is coming, and I already have quite a bit of that one, so I didn't take advantage of that either. And then the Sweet Symmetry is a new one for me, so I picked up some of that as well. So get it while you can, 15% off, super good deal. Okay, so that's that. The other thing is my host code for the month is MUMSPFDZ. MUMSPFDZ, or DS, sorry. So that's also on my website, on my homepage. If you are interested in any of the products that I'm showcasing today, they're all for sale on in my store. Just go to cardsbycheryl.com, click shop with me, and you can jump to and peruse the online catalog and shop away. So use your host code so that I can send you some rewards as they come in. All right, so the card that we're going to make today looks like this. And the Designer Series paper I used is actually a specialty paper with the acetate and the gold on the front. I'll show you that. I don't think this is available anymore, but I have a bunch. So if you'd like some, just message me. It's called the Golden Garden Designer Series Specialty Acetate. And there's 3 different designs and it coordinates really nicely with the, the Fine Art Floral Designer Paper. So this is a brand new package too, which I'm happy to share a little bit with if some of you would like this paper as well. But this is the card that I made. Some other cards that I made that go with the hand-penned stamp set is this one right here. And these are a couple different cards that I made using this set. And so there are some different flowers here versus here. And I just thought this was really pretty. And this is the new black and white gingham ribbon that's available in our new catalog too. So these cards stand up on their own, just like so, and then they pull out where you can write your message or you can stamp another message. And then I put another piece of white on the back so that you could continue to write because it's not a very big space here. But these just look so cute sitting on someone's desk. And you bend this a little bit, they stand up just perfectly. And they're just an adorable little, I can't move the camera to show you the view forward, but they're just an adorable little card to keep on your desk or your mantle or on a shelf in your kitchen or something. Really super cute. So I'm going to make one of these for you today, and I'm going to be using the Art Gallery set with the dies, coordinating dies, and I haven't decided what sentiment we'll do, but we'll figure that out down the road. So this set, like I said, has coordinating dies. These are all just kind of extra pieces that I had when I was playing around with it. And we're going to do the multi-layer stamping with these florals. So I'm just going to set those out. I'm going to set this aside for a second. And let's see, what else did I want to tell you before we get started? Oh, and the ink colors we're going to be using are all of these, which are the colors that coordinate with that designer series paper. So Parapizzazz, Flirty Flamingo, Petal Pink, Poppy Parade, Real Red. Actually, this is an extra one. It's not on the designer series paper, but I added it myself for a little bit more shadow dimension on the florals. And then Bumblebee and Pool Party is the color cardstock we're going to use for the pot. So there's our inks that we're using today. And let's get some supplies out. We're going to need several blocks. Did you guys hear that noise? It's the thing to deter moles in your front yard. It's a stake that you pound into the ground, and it makes this annoying noise like every, 15 minutes or so. It's supposed to make the moles go away, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So let's see, we need blocks, we need a chamois, which I have here. Oh, and I wanted to grab, I think we might try using some of these too, which are my blender blender sponges. Okay, need some paper. I always start with 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 sheets of pre-cut paper because they're just easier to run through your die machine rather than starting with the big piece and having to cut it down. So I keep a stack of these on hand to use when I'm creating. And I also want to use my Stamp and Pierce mat because we are using photopolymer, and this gives it a really nice cushion to get going. Okay, so the flowers, blooms that we're going to make, we need three of the big ones, and I did add in one little one here, and then we need a couple of stems. So that's what we're going to be stamping at the moment. Okay, so let's start with the very first layer stamp in this set is this one here, which has the most, basically, the background of the bloom. So we're going to start with that one. I'm using a size D block, and the first color we're going to use is, we're going to combine Petal Pink and Flirty Flamingo for this. And we're also going to want a piece of paper to stamp off on. And I had one here ready to go. So keep this. This is just a blank piece of paper that we're going to stamp off on to take away some of the ink so that it's not quite so vibrant in some cases. So the first layer we're going to put down is going to be the lightest layer. And so we're going to start with Petal Pink. And let's see, we're going to ink this up real good. It's a very juicy one. I don't use Petal Pink very often, but so we're going to stamp that down. Then if you wanted to, this one we didn't stamp off first because it's actually pretty light. Then if you wanted to use your blender brushes, I don't think I have a Petal Pink going, so I'm just going to start with this way. You can dab into your darker color and sponge on. Well, let's try this. I don't want to do that. Let's get rid of this ink here. Wipe this off. So if you want to really rich looking flower, you can stamp in your Petal Pink and then stamp in your Flirty Flamingo and just dab on a little bit of shadowing and kind of in the center, like that. Let's see how this stamps. Oh, pretty. Isn't that pretty? Wow, that turned out really good. Love it. Okay, so then the next layer of this particular flower is going to be this guy right here. And we're going to put him on another D-size block. And we're going to do Flirty Flamingo, but not full strength. So we're going to stamp this off once, and then we're going to stamp the second generation on top. So you get a nice little blend of color there. Get this out of the way. Okay, so the third layer is this little guy right here. And he will fit nicely on your little tiny A size block. And that's going to be full strength on this one. So you get a gradation of color there. Isn't that pretty? Okay, so there's one flower. Now we can go back and finish this one too. And so that's going to be Flirty Flamingo, stamped off once. And these don't line up perfectly, so you don't have to be super, super meticulous about how you line it up. And then we're going to go do like the little center. It's not, I don't know if it's a stamen or what, but that's going to be full strength there. See the difference in the two? This one kind of had a little bit more stamping to it. Okay, clean these guys off. And we're going to move to a different color. So the next color we're going to do is, let me see here. Let's do a bumblebee, a yellow one. And that one I don't have two colors for. I just stamp off. But you know what? We can try doing maybe some Mango Melody with it. That might, or maybe Calypso Coral. Or actually, huh? Let me see here. Let's try a Mango Melody and see if that provides enough of a difference in coloration. Okay, so we're gonna start not full strength on the yellow. We're gonna stamp this off once. And then find a blank spot on your palette, paper I should say, and put that down. Then we're going to grab this one and we're going to go full strength and put that down like so. And then we're going to try on it as a test and see how dark that comes out. Oh yeah, I think that'll be pretty. So we're using the smaller stamp to put the stamens in, and you just, it's not super prominent, but it's just enough of a difference. It's just a little subtlety. So I think that's really pretty too. Okay, so there's that one. I think we need to do one more flower. We're going to do, I think, the Poppy Parade with the Flirty Flamingo, and then a little bit of dark centering with the Real Red. So I need another piece of paper because I don't think I can. Well, maybe I can. Okay, where did my big flower go? Here it is. So clean him off. And we're going to start with Flirty Flamingo. We're going to do full strength. I can get another flower in here. Good. Full strength. Oh, pretty. Then we're going to go to the second step and do, get this out of the way. We're going to do Poppy Parade. If I can get it open. There we go. Do a little Poppy Parade. And I'm not quite, I can't remember if I did this one full strength or not. So let's do a quick test. Yeah, that's going to be too similar to this color. So I think we go full strength with the poppy. Oh, pretty. And then we take a little bit of the real red, which is just a smidge more dark than the poppy. Let's just see. Oh, actually, it's really close. Maybe I did a darker. Oh, let's try it. Yeah, you can't really tell. It's still a really pretty flower, but you can't. The two reds are pretty close. I could jump down to, or jump to a darker. Let's do cherry cobbler. Let's see what that does. Oh yeah, there's a little bit better. You see the difference? A little bit darker right there. Pretty. Okay, and now we need to do a small flower, and that is not double stamping, that is just single stamping. So that's easy. What color should we do the small flower in? Let's do, the small flower is this one right here. And that fits on a C stamp, I think, or C block, yep. So these are the colors of the big blooms. Let's do a couple different ones and we'll be able to play. Let's do a bumblebee. Oh, I wonder if you could use this in that. I bet you can. Let's see, that was Mango Melody. I'm kind of all over the board on this with the colors. Let's see what happens when you do that. Yeah, that's all right. If you wanted to add it, you could. I'm not that much of a fan, so I also have red ink all over me, probably on my face too. We'll do a red one. Let's see, do we want to do Poppy Parade. Ouch. Boy, this one's stiff. I'm going to do Poppy Parade. And then, oh my gosh, I love that color. Let's do, if you do more than you need, then you have choices when you're arranging your little bouquet. So I'm going to do a light petal pink one. And then I'm also going to do a flirty flamingo, just so we have lots of choices. And then maybe even two bouquets worth. So when you're doing all the stamping for these bouquets, just mass produce. Stamp out a bunch of flowers like I did. I'm not going to show them to you because they're all scattered over my desk. But then you just have so many choices when you're designing your little bouquet. Okay, so the last thing we need to stamp are some accenting leaves, and those are also here. Just going to grab the stem and throw it on a clean block. This doesn't have any double stamping, but what you can do, I'll show you. So you could stamp it once like that. That's just plain. You can stamp it again here like this, and then grab maybe, some garden green, and grab a garden green sponge dauber. That's granny apple, mossy meadow. I might not have one. Nope, I don't have one yet, so I'm going to grab a clean one, and then I will label it later. So grab a, sorry, I'm in the wrong stamp now. This is garden green. We're going to ink this up, garden green, and we're going to put a little extra color in here and stamp it. See how pretty? Oh, you know what? I kind of scooched it. And it made a little bit of a, let's do a clean one. Made a little bit of a pattern on that, which I don't really care for, so we'll redo this. So, clean it off. Granny apple green is the first layer. Garden green. And you just tap, tap, tap straight up and down. and then press. There, very pretty. I like that. Okay, so I need to set that aside so I remember to label it later. All right. Let's see, we have three leaves, so that'll be enough. We'll cut those out. Okay, now I am going to pause and go cut all these out, and I will be right back. Okay, I'm back, and here are all of our pretty flowers we cut out, and we have more than enough to make one card. And next thing we need to do is I need to show you how to make the flower pot base and also the piece that these flowers get adhered to. So I'm going to set these aside because we will decorate later. I'm going to grab my trimmer and I'm going to cut two flower pots because, let's see if I can do this without keeping it in view. I liked the petal pink. I think I like the petal pink, but I couldn't decide. So I'm going to cut two of them. So the dimensions for this are super easy. You just line it up at 3 inches. And then there's your first base. I'm just going to cut one of these in case I want it in the blue. So just a 3-inch piece, 3 by 11. And then you're going to score it at 3, 6, and 9. So super, like I said, super easy. So you're basically just dealing with the square. 3, 6, and 9. I'm going to do the same with this one. There's 9. 6 and 3. Okay, then we're going to cut the base for the pullout piece, and that is 2 1/4 by 4 1/4. I'm going to do it this way. Two and a quarter by 4 1/4. We'll do another one in case we go with the pink. 1 1/4 by 4 1/4. So there's those pieces. And then the piece for the white layer, I'm just going to grab one of my pre-cut sheets. And we're going to go 4 1/8. So you just want 1/8 inch smaller than this piece. So we're going to cut 4 1/8 by 2 1/8. 2 1/8. You're going to get 2 out of these. 2 1/8. Yeah, perfect. So there's our two pieces for that. If you want to put another piece on the back, we might as well, right? So then you're going to cut, if you're just doing one flower pot, then you need 2. Obviously, if you're doing 2 flower pots, you need 4. And I think I'm going to just get these cut so I can finish the cards completely. There. That's all the cutting we need to do for now until we get ready to do the sentiment. So the way that I made let me show you how you fold these first. Okay, so you've got a 3-inch square, a 3-inch square, a 3-inch square, and then this piece right here is the shorter edge. That shorter edge is going to be the flap for your pot. Okay, so you're gonna take that short edge and fold that down. Then you're just going to Z fold. So this folds up on top of that, and then this folds back like that. So you essentially just have a Z fold, right? With the short piece being the front. So this back piece is going to be the kickstand, and then this is going to be the rim of the pot, and then this will be the part where you tuck your card in. So, then we do need to make a template, because if you make more than one of these cards, it's just easy to have a template. And I had my template somewhere. Oh, it's in my, somewhere in here. So I lied, we do need to cut some more. But so I have a template that's already made, and it is 3 inches at the top. It's a 3x3 square, and then it's 3 inches at the top and 2 1/4 inches at the bottom. So the way that I cut that was, let's see, do I have a scrap that's I can use that's 3 inches? So I'm gonna go make a 3-inch square out of just some scrap paper. Then you're going to want to cut an eighth of an inch. No, is that right? How much are we going to cut? Let's measure. I never find my rulers when I need it. So we're going to cut 3/8. That's what it, that's right. 3/8 of an inch off each side of the base. And so how you do that on the trimmer is you line up one corner in the gutter of your trimmer, and then it's easier to do down here. So you count off 3/8. So you got 1, 2, 3/8 is right there. So you're gonna line your corner up right there on the 3/8 mark. Hold it there, and then put your other corner in the gutter of the blade cutter. Close it, hold down, and cut. So now you've got your nice 3/8 inch angle. You're going to turn it around, you're going to do the same thing. So 1, 2, 3/8 right there. 1, 2, 3/8 right there. And then this corner goes right here in the center of the cutting blade, and you cut. So it's not perfect, but hey, it's going to work. It's going to be great. So if you wanted to be brave and do that with this piece and line it up and do the same method cutting, you can. I just found it easier, and Julie Davison showed this trick on her video. That's where I got it from. So I just found it easier to do it this way. So you just line this up, grab a good strong scissors, because you are cutting through 3 layers of cardstock here. Whoops, get back in camera. 3 layers here. So then you just hold it and cut like that. And then if you're right-handed, you're going to want to flip it in your hands and hold it and cut. So now we have our flower pot shape, and now we're just going to trim the end. And on the other flower pot that I made, I used the scalloped edge. And that came from the hand-penned suite. It's this guy right here. So if you have this suite or this stamp set and die bundle, you can use this and run it through your die trimmer, which I will do on this one. And then on the pink one, I'll do something a little different. So here we're just going to Z-fold this just like that. We're going to cut our template. Like that. And on this one, I don't know if you guys have these. These are so old. I don't even know how old they are, but they're decorative scissors cutters. And I just thought it would be fun to try that on this. So I'm just eyeballing. It's about an inch from the fold to where you're going to start cutting, but you don't have to be super precise. You can make it as wide or as narrow as you want. I'm just going to eyeball it here and go right about there. And then you want to line your scissors back up again in the same groove so you have a nice even pattern. And there you have a decorative edge on your pot. Isn't that cute? So that's using, these are Fiskars paper edgers. I don't even know if they're still available. If they are, I'll try to find them for you to link them. And then if you wanted to do something, you know, you could use any border die that you have to give it any kind of a trim look. So I'm just going to put this on here right about there. I'm going to use a piece of my post-it note tape to hold it down. Post-it tape is getting dirty. I need to start throw this away and use some fresh stuff. I reuse it again and again and again because the sticky lasts quite a long time on it. So here we have one pot. Let's get this out of the way. And here's our second pot. I don't know which one you like better. I like them both. So the next thing we need to do is grab some ribbon, but I also put a, after we put the ribbon on, then I put the tape down. So let's do that first. And the ribbon is what we're using today. This came in the Fine Art Floral Suite. It's called Fine Art, and it's this really pretty fabric ribbon with gold speckles in it. So you're only going to need, I'm going to say like 11 or 12 inches, but let's just be safe. Yeah, let's go with 12 inches. And you're not going to want to wrap it around this part. You're just going to wrap it around, because this is going to be your kickstand, and you don't want that tied down, because otherwise it won't stand up. So you're just going to wrap this around the front like that. This is going to hold everything closed so that you can slide your note card in. So I just tie this simple little bow. Oh, actually, you know what? I didn't do a bow, did I? No, I just did a knot. So it's just a simple little knot. Makes it even easier. Like so. Trim off the end. Then what I do is I flip it over, I grab some tear and tape, and I straddle the edge of the ribbon with the paper so that I'm securing the ribbon down at the same time. Give that a good press. And then remove your backer. And close the back kickstand. So now you have this part. And it doesn't open very far. So what I like to do is just kind of coach it a little bit. Just give it a little bend. You could score it if you wanted. But I don't think you need to. So there, now it stands beautifully. And we are ready to cut the design for the front of this. So as I said, this is that designer acetate paper. It's kind of got two sides. It's got a silver side or a gold side, but we're going to use the gold side. So this is a 3x3 square. And I'm going to go back to the template we made. And just line this up. Cut it. Like that, and that just slides right in there like so, and we're going to trim off a little bit at the end. Now the way I adhere this down so that you can't see anything is also tear and tape at the very top. So I put that at the top, and let's get the backer off. Oops. It's always easier with your take your pick tool. and carefully, without sticking it down, carefully slide it in. If you, without pressing very hard, so that you don't glue it before it's in place. So slide that all the way up, which I think I have. You can actually do this step before you tied the ribbon so that you didn't have to fuss with it like I just did. I don't know why I just thought of that, but okay, so now you have your little piece in place. I'm gonna trim off this extra, just like so. And then I am gonna take a glue dot just for a little extra. You don't want it flipping up. I'm gonna take a glue dot and see that little dot right there? There's a little dot, a circle dot. I'm gonna put a glue dot right behind it. There, you can't even hardly see it. So here's our flower pot. Now we're going to put together our coordinating insert. And I'm going to use my Seal Plus. And you just center it right on, just like so. And the same for the back. Oops. Seal Plus is strong. Gotta be careful if you run it too fast. Nope. Let's just cut that off. Yeah. And redo. There. And then center this right here on the back. If you did want to stamp your sentiment on here, you might want to stamp that first before you glue it down. But so now this just fits in here like so. Okay. The next thing we want to do is use a pencil and take a little mark. And just because you want to make sure your floral blooms don't come too much further down this edge, because you're going to run into a problem once you hit here. Because of the ribbon, it's gonna stop it from coming all the way in. So when you design your floral pattern, you wanna kinda keep that in mind. Okay, so we're gonna pull this out. The other thing you wanna keep in mind is the size of the envelope, so that you'd also stay within the confines of how big your flower bouquet is. So what I like to do is grab an envelope and lay this down at the bottom, and then slide this in, so lay this down, slide this in, and then you design while everything is in there. Actually, we drew the line, so we don't really have to do that. I'm going to take the pot away, leave this down here like that, and so when you're putting your blooms together, see how you want to make sure you don't run over the outside edge of the envelope. And then maybe we'll stick this one right here. I can't decide which one I like better. I think that one. We will tuck that one in there, kind of like so. And then here's another trick I do. Grab your post-it tape or any kind of bow tack tape that you have. If I can find mine, here it is. This is awesome. I buy usually two of these at a time because I use so much of it. Just take a piece, once you get your florals designed how you want them, just take a piece of your post-it tape and tape it all together like that. Just make sure a piece of the tape is touching every part of each floral, so you can pick it up like that. Now, what you want to do is hold it where Let's see. We're going to need our pot again. What did I do with it? Here it is. So we're going to want to put insert it into the flower pot. So that goes all the way down. Then we're going to push the flowers down as far as you can without until it hits this ribbon. Flip it over, and I take another pencil and I just mark the guide of where I want the glue to go when we put the glue on the back. So then we know where things are gonna get glued. And I might be ready for a new, oh, there we go. That's way too much. I'm going to slide some of this off. There. And you can pick up some of the overlapping parts and tuck some glue under there like that. Then we're going to take our piece and lay it back down right where those lines are. And test it while the glue is still a little bit wet. Yep, that looks good. Give it a good press. Gently peel off your tape. Oops, you see that moved because it's not totally here down yet, but that's why you gently peel it off so that you don't disturb it too much. And then you're going to tuck some glue under the top layer flowers that didn't get any from the back side. Just like that. So everything's nice and glued down. Then what I did was I took some greenery. You don't even have to do this greenery part if you don't want to, but I took some of the greenery stems and I cut them up and I'm just going to tuck them in. Just a couple. Maybe right there. Again, make sure you're staying within the confines of your envelope size. Tuck this in right there. I think I want one more because 3 is always a good number. And I think we should probably tuck this one right there. I love it. Okay. You can erase your little pencil mark if it's showing. And there's our flower. Isn't that pretty? Now, for the sentiment, I told you we hadn't decided what we were going to do yet, so let's just take a quick peek. If you wanted to stick with only the art gallery as your theme, as your set that you're using, let's see here. What do we want to do? How about best wishes? We'll do that. That's easy. And the best wishes fits inside this little guy. I'm pretty sure it does. Oh no, you know what? I'm changing my mind on the fly. Pulling an audible. I'm gonna do I miss you. Because I have a card, I have a friend that I want to send this to. So I miss you with this small piece for the die. And you should have some scrap white paper from cutting those other pieces that you can use. Grab this real fast, stick this on a block. Let's see what color ink do we want to do. I think I'm going to do the poppy. I think that would be really pretty. get this on a little bit straighter. Okay, so there's that. Now we're going to die cut this. Guess what we're going to use again, guys? My post-it tape. There. Cut this out real fast. And then I like to give it a little bit of a background. How did I get yellow ink all over that? That's gotta go. Messy. I am a messy stamper. Then using a scrap from, this would be perfect. From the, this was the scrap from the flower pot. What I do is I just tape that down. Actually, I'm going to use a little bit of glue. And I like to use my tweezers so that I don't get my, oops, hands all sticky. And of course, I just dropped it. I put it on a fresh side that's not going to be sticky. So put that up there in the corner like that. Grab your snips. And then just cut that out. So now you can either adhere it straight down like that, or you can put a little hole in it and have it dangle from the bow, which is, I think, what I'd like to do. And I used to have a hole punch that I don't know where it went anymore. So I am using this punch. I don't recall the name of it, but it's, do you see it's got the little hole punch right there? We're going to use that. So what I do is I'm going to put a little dot right where I want the hole to go. If you can see that, the little dot right there. That way when I run it through this punch, I know exactly where it's going to punch. Like so, there. Then we are going to grab some twine, and the twine that I like to use is this stuff, any white twine or whatever. I think I'm going to use, white, so there's a little bit of a contrast. You could use this color, but I think I'm going to go with white. I can get it out. And this just needs like 6 inches or so. Put the two ends together like that. Thread them through from the back. Sometimes it helps to fold them over and push them through. And sometimes you need a tweezers to pull it through, just like so. Then you're gonna loop it through so that it catches like that. Take this, run it under the knot of the ribbon here. And then you're gonna tie a bow. Like so. So you get two bows on the front of this guy. There. There's our finished card. What do you guys think? If you redid this, would you do it in blue? I've got enough flowers here. I could do another one. I'd probably do one in blue. I think this is really pretty too, though. I love it. I hope you guys love it too. I'm not going to keep you any longer because I think this ended up being quite a long video. But hopefully you got what you needed from it. Again, the dimensions are super easy. You just need a 3-inch strip by 11. Score it 3/6 9 inches. Z fold it. Wrap a ribbon around it. And then design your bouquet. Super easy, guys. Thank you for watching, if I still have you. Again, if you like any of these products, they're available in my online store. Just click or go to cardsbycheryl.com and click shop with me, and that will jump you to my Stampin' Up! Store. And if you would like to use this host code, I would appreciate it. For July, it's MUMSPFDS. And orders are much appreciated. I always send little gifts to all my customers who order from me, so I'd love to earn your business. And if you are interested in some of the this paper that's no longer available, message me and we can work something out where I can do a partial. I have 2.5 full packs. So for this particular project, you only need a 3 by 3 square. So I could work something out where you could do a quarter pack with you or whatever. If you're interested, just let me know. You can message me at cheryl@cardsbycheryl.com, or I'm on Instagram and Facebook, and my website also. All right, I'll stop talking now. Thanks for hanging out there with me, guys. Give me a thumbs up and a like if you enjoyed this video. I'd appreciate it. Talk to you soon. Bye.